Hello, welcome to Maths with Jay.
Here we want to eliminate the theta from these equations, so we want to end up with one equation linking x and y. So let's start by numbering the equations. So we've got equations 1 and 2, and we've got sine theta and cos theta involved, so we're looking for an identity that involves those two. And of course, the one that we want is sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is 1. So now all we need to do is make sine theta the subject of equation 1 and cos theta the subject of equation 2. So starting with equation 1, we can subtract 7 from both sides and divide by 2. So sine theta is the same as x minus 7, all divided by 2. And then using equation 2, we can make cos theta the subject. So here we want to subtract 3 from both sides and then divide by 5. And now we're ready to use our identity. So we've got sine theta squared, so that's all of x minus 7 over 2 squared. So we'll put the whole lot in brackets. And then we've got cos theta squared, so we want to put the y minus 3 over 5 in brackets there and square it. And then that's equal to 1. So you might like to maybe write this as x minus 7 all squared over 2 squared or over 4, plus y minus 3 squared all over 25 or 5 squared equal to 1. You may even want to multiply both sides by, what's 4 times 25, by 100. But we have, at this stage, eliminated the theta from the equations. We've got a Cartesian equation, and you might like to think about what would the graph look like?